Hey, Leanne, I said hold it. Will you come in here? What do you think you're doing?
Kevin, I couldn't help it.
You couldn't help trespassing.
Please. I just wanted to see him, okay? Because CJ told me that he was really, really sick and I was worried.
Well, he's fine. Plus, he thought you'd just creep up here when I wasn't around,
I'm
right?
I'm sorry. Kevin, wait a minute. What are you doing? Kevin, you're not gonna call the police, are you?
Now, children, I just came to check on you. Lucky I did, because I have got to go back out. So, stay out of trouble. I'll see you soon.
Where is she going?
Blair! I can't believe this is happening.
Okay.
I cannot believe this is happening.
Just take it easy,
Don't
okay?
tell me to take it easy. Do not tell me to take it easy. Blair is going to Cassie's wedding where I'm supposed to be a bridesmaid.
Tina?
No! Just...
Andrew, will you have this woman to be your wife? To live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as ye both shall live?
I will.
Will all of you...
Now look here, Marty. I am not going to let you ruin Andrew's wedding.
Try and stop me!
Marty!
We will.
And I won't. Marty! Where do you think you're going?
Let go of me. I've got a monkey wrench to deliver.
Will you stop this? You don't even know what you're doing.
I know exactly what I'm doing. Now let go of me.
So you're going to ruin Andrew's wedding. Now, is that going to make you happy?
Yes.
Marty! No. Marty, for God's sakes, for Megan's sakes, stop this.
Stop it. Megan has nothing to do with
it. Megan has everything to do with this. Come on. Megan loved Andrew. She would not have wanted you to hurt him this way. She would not have wanted you to hurt yourself this way. She cared about you.
Oh, Marty. Honey, you're not hurting anybody but yourself. And for what? Don't you understand? Nothing you can do here is going to cause anything more than a passing unpleasantness.
In the name of God, I, Andrew Carpenter, take you, Cassie Callison, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until we are parted by death. This is my solemn vow.
Darling, Andrew and Cassie's love is not going to go away, and I think you know that.
Oh, you poor child.
Oh, Marty, stop. Just let it out. Just let it out.
How can you marry Cassie? And I love you.
Cassie?
In the name of God, I, Cassie Callison, take you, Andrew Carpenter, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer,
in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until we are parted by death. This is my solemn vow.
Marty, what's wrong with you? What's wrong?
I don't know.
My God, you're shaking. Your eyes cold. Honey, you should be in bed. I'm going to take you home.
Leave me alone.
No,
leave
I will me not leave you home. I will not. You're trembling like a leaf.
Cassie and Andrew, you have given yourselves to each other by solemn vows, by the joining of the hands, and by the giving and receiving of a ring. I pronounce you husband and wife. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Amen.
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 Come on, I want you to just lean on me. I'm taking you home. Just lean on me.
Andrew, you may kiss your bride.
Come on, honey, don't cry.
Don't
right?
touch me!
No, that's not exactly fair, okay? Now, you went along with this plan from the beginning. Drugging Blair, throwing her in the sack with Jorge. I mean, you came up with Jorge, right? Now, all we did was we underestimated what a conniving, ruthless little Blair is, you know? Spider spinning her web, waiting for the next fly to land.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
What?
What about poor Jorge?
Jorge?
Jorge.
Ah, my darling. I have been waiting so long. Ever since I first put in eyes on you.
And that is all you are going to put on me.
What do you mean, my darling?
Well, I will just let the Immigration Department explain it all to you. They'll make it perfectly clear why they're taking away your green card.
Green card? Please. Are there not things I can do for you, huh?
Yeah, there is something you can do for me. You can sign your name right here.
I do not understand.
Jorge. One, sign the paper. Two, get out of Landview. Three, don't look back. Got it?
Wait. You've been here before?
Kevin, I've only been here a few times. Look, all I've done is I've just stood outside the window and I've just looked at him, you know? I just wanted to see if his hair was growing and stuff. And what kind of clothes he was wearing and little legs.
Are you okay?
You.
For what?
Kevin, I violated the restraining order. You could have called the police and you didn't. I'll go.
Leanne, wait.
Sometimes he knows exactly what I'm saying. Of course, yeah. I've never said that to anybody because I think they'd think I'm crazy, you know?
No, they wouldn't.
No.
You're smart, aren't you?
All right, it's nap time.
Oh, God. Oh, God, I can't believe I stayed this long. I was supposed to meet Jason at the wedding reception. Oh, I'd love to put him down for his nap, though.
No, it's okay. I'll take care of it.
Okay, okay. Bye. Bye, Angel. No, don't cry. Here. Mommy will see you soon.
Okay.
Would that be okay? I mean, like, do you think I could see him sometime?
I don't know, Liam. I gotta think this through, all right?
Okay. Okay. Look, we'll talk about it later then.
Right. Come on, say goodbye. Say goodbye to Mommy. Okay, Tiger. All right, it's time for you to go down. There you go. Got your little rattle there. Okay.
Hey. Did I mention how glad I am that you're here?
No, you haven't said a word.
I am so glad that you're here.
Me too. And I want to be with you whenever I can. But I need to know one thing. Hmm. When are you going to make your peace with Leanne?
Marty, you gave me a scare, you know.
I'm fine, Vicky.
Really? It seemed as if somebody pulled the rug right out from under you.
Yeah, well, someone did. Thanks for catching me. I'm sorry I was such a nuisance.
How do you manage this big house all by yourself?
Oh, who says I'm managing?
Serious? You don't have a housekeeper or staff?
You could tell? I guess Aunt Kiki let them go when she left.
Oh, Marty, you can't take care of a house this size by yourself. You know, I could help you find someone.
No, that's okay.
A cleaning service or a gardener.
That's okay, Vicky.
Well, it's no problem, darling.
No! Don't help me! No!
I don't want to intrude.
Well, you have! You've intruded all over the place with your opinions and your concerns and your opinion. I don't want Betty! Not yours or anyone else's. Andrew gave me enough Betty to last a lifetime.
You've never looked better.
Never felt better, Max. I wish you a thousand lives together, past, present, and future.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm worried. I haven't seen Tina yet.
No, she better have a good excuse, like multiple fractures.
No, this is serious. I'm very worried.
This is not a day to be worried. This is a day to be happy. Now, come on. Look at Andrew. There's a happy man. Look at Cassie. There's a happy woman. You and I play our cards right, I could be a happy man and you could be a happy woman.
I am a happy woman.
Yeah.
And when Valentine's Day rolls around, I'm going to be just a little teeny itty bit happier. I'm going to be so happy that the birds and the bees, they're going to bust wide open with jealousy.
Good news, you're going to be a lot happier.
Ooh. Oh.
Mm.
Clint, darling, have you seen Vicky?
No, why?
I don't know. I saw her leave the church kind of upset, and she hasn't come back yet. I just wondered if, well, if anything happened.
I don't know. Excuse me.
I could go on like this all day.
Yeah?
Yes. I think we're about done with the reception.
Is this my dad talking to me here?
Yes, proud father.
Yeah?
We'll find some. You know, Andrew, you and your brother William came out of a very special love between your mother and me. And today, to witness that kind of love between you and Cassie.
Dad, I just thank God that you were here to see me.
All right, you two. Break it up.
Yeah.
Jason needs us for pictures.
Yes, ma'am.
Billy, is everything all right?
Yes, sir.
What's the matter? You look a little bit upset.
It's Marty's sick, look. I'm worried about her.
What happened?
Well, she got sick over at the church, and then Mrs. Buchanan rushed her off to her home.
Vicky?
Excuse Excuse me, General.
Sure. Jade, isn't it?
Yeah, it was William. It was beautiful. Towards the end of his life, he used to hold it in his hand. He found it cool, soothing. It's very special, thank you. Oh, William would have wanted to be here very much. He loved you, Andrew. And he would have loved you, Kathy.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Thank you, John.
Excuse me, Sheila.
Hi, Hank. Can I interrupt?
Sure.
I was wondering if I might ask you that business question that I mentioned earlier.
Yeah, shoot.
Well, it's odd, but I've been very curious. Is there any way in the world at all that Carlo Hesser could still be alive?
Carlo Hesser alive? Come on, Renee. How could that be? I mean, the man was shot and cremated. Is that what you wanted to ask me earlier? Why?
I don't know. It's just this strange idea popped into my head.
Joey, excuse me.
Yeah.
You seen your mother?
No. Why? Did she leave already?
Kathy. Don't you look beautiful?
No, I wasn't supposed to say that to you, and I will. You look absolutely gorgeous.
Thank you. I feel just awful that I had to miss part of the ceremony, but this divorce is like a full-time job. Was it everything that you'd hoped it would be?
Absolutely. Except Tina never showed up. She was one of my bridesmaids. I don't understand how someone can forget something like this.
Well, you know, sometimes that girl just doesn't think.
Oh! Look, Tina, I'm really sorry about this. I know you've been looking forward to Cassie's wedding for a long time, and so have I.
Yeah.
I mean, I've been thinking for weeks about sitting in that church, watching the most beautiful bridesmaid in the world walk it down that aisle.
You're sweet, Kane.
You're sweet, Kane. Locked in here for quite a while. It's a shame to let all this go to waste, huh?
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, we got those, smoked oysters.
Mm-hmm.
Double ham.
Yeah, well, I was thinking of a different kind of appetite. After all, man does not live by ham alone.
Here? I didn't really want to leave until I was sure you were all right.
So are you sure now?
Well, you certainly have a novel way of telling me to leave.
Look, I told you I don't want your pity. Oh, Vicky, wait. I just wanted to say thanks.
You're welcome.
And, about that offer about you helping me out with this place, I'm gonna think about it, okay?
Okay. Do that.
What a place,
huh? Yeah, imagine rambling around in there all by yourself.
Huh. Oh. Billy, what are you doing here? What's wrong?
Well, that's what we came to find out.
Yeah, I saw you leave the church with Marty, and then she didn't look so good.
She wasn't doing terribly well, but I think she's better now. Yeah.
I'm gonna go check on her.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. I got a little upset earlier, that's all. And then I ran into Marty in the vestibule, and she was hell-bent on destroying Andrew and Cassie's wedding. I wasn't about to let that happen, and then she became ill.
Well, that's why you left the church, is it? Well, I don't think Marty Saybrook's situation is what upset you this morning.
What do you mean?
I think it's that business with Clint. My having read your diary about you having been to Princess Grace's wedding.
Don't, please don't bring
it up. Well, it's true. You and I know it. Now Clint knows it. Vicky, when you gave me that diary, you knew I'd love the person who wrote it. And I do. I cherish that person. But that is a private part of you that you've never shared with Clint. Because you never thought he would understand. Isn't
that so? Please stop now. You're interrogating me as if I were a suspect.
Well, that's right. I suspect you of loving me. You do, don't you? You love me, don't you?
Yes, I do. Oh, God, yes, I do. I love you.
Devil fruit cake. It's the best. I ought to know I made it.
You get out of here.
I'm with you, sugar.
People that can have a good time, they're my kind of.
You okay, Luna?
Yeah, I'm okay. Just felt a cold chill in here is all.
Max, I know that this isn't the time or the place. This is very important.
Well, just make it fast. I gotta get back to Luna.
Things are getting out of hand. Today, the day of my cousin's wedding, Tina and Kane tried to drug me.
Trying to drug you? Oh, come on.
Not only am I sure, I have proof. Their half-baked plan was to have me wake up in bed with some gigolo and then photograph me in a compromising position.
Wait a minute. This is pretty far out.
It's true, Max. I swear it. I don't know how much more this I can take. I'm trying to be strong. I'm trying not to fall apart, but it is hard, Max. It is really, really hard.
The strawberries and cream look beautiful. Why don't you take them, too?
No, I'm okay. I'm all right. Really.
Hey.
Hey. Kind of late, aren't you? Where you been?
I was over at Lanphier.
You went to Lanphier?
Jason, I found out that Duke was sick, all right? I was really worried. I went over there, and I looked through the window, and he seemed fine. I mean, Kevin was playing with him. And then Kevin saw me.
He saw you?
It was okay. Jason, the guy was actually nice to me. He was. I mean, he even let me hold Duke.
Wait a minute. Kevin let you hold Duke?
And I guess I don't have to tell you how much holding my baby meant to me. Jason, if I could only get him to change his mind about the visitation rights, you know, even if he would give me one day a month, it would be okay. If it was just something I could count on, you know? What am I supposed to do to get him to do it? I mean, what do I have to do?
Kevin, you can't go on like this. Leanne is Duke's mother, and she loves him. No, I think you should try and make your peace with her.
You're right. You're right. I hate saying that, but you are. I just got to think this thing through, you know?
And you will. And you will be fair, because that is who you are. Right? And you are great in bed. Of course, I'm speaking from limited experience.
You know, the cabin is still available.
Very tempting. But I've got to go home.
Boy, you don't sound too thrilled about that. Oh, your father.
Mm-hmm. You mean the man with the big scowl?
I'm gonna go with you.
No, bad idea.
Hey! Rachel, don't do that to me, all right? Don't shut me out like I count for nothing. I count for something, don't I?
Clint, I can't help but wonder why Vicky left the church in such a hurry. And while we're at it, where has the good general, the father of the groom, gone?
Save it, Dorian.
Vicky's gone, Sloane's gone. It's very strange.
Why do you always have to think the worst of people?
I just call them as I see them.
Excuse me, I think I need some fresh air. Excuse me.
I have waited so long for you to say that you love me.
I shouldn't have said it. I had no business saying it.
You have made me very happy.
Don't, please don't. Because what I feel and how I spend the rest of my life, they have to be two separate things now. I have a family, and what we're doing is playing with fire.
I don't care.
Why can't something work like my soft cleanser without...
Let's just cool it, okay?
Look, no. I don't feel cool about you, all right? I care about you. And if there's going to be trouble with your father and you, or if there's trouble with Leanne and me, I want us to be there for each other, all right?
Look, I want you to be there when I talk to my father about us, but not tonight. I'm not ready for a big blow-up. Please.
All right, well, then how about a return trip to the cabin? I'll get Kim to babysit.
Sounds good.
Hey, Dad.
Kevin?
How's the wedding?
Very nice.
Well, Rachel and I were just leaving.
Before you go, you seen your mother?
Mom, no. She's not here. But wasn't she at the wedding with you?
Yes, but she disappeared.
Oh, sex always gives me an appetite. Kane!
Oh. Yes. Oh. And I always say, if you're going to be locked up in somebody's pantry, it might as well be somebody with expensive taste.
Mm. Oh. Kane.
Mm-hmm.
Since our time with Jorge failed, does that mean that you're still going to testify that Blair and Max slept together?
Could you pass the nut,
please? No, Kane, I'm serious. Are you going to testify that Blair and Max committed adultery?
Well, honey, you worry too much, okay? Now, the trial is months away. By then, you and I will have come up with another brilliant plan to nail Blair, okay?
Mm-hmm. As brilliant as this one.
Come on, honey, don't you have faith in me?
I want to, Kane. I do. I don't know. All I can say is you have to do your best, because if Max and Luna end up getting hurt, I swear I will never forgive you.
You can count on it, okay? I'm not going to hurt them. And I would never hurt you.
What was that all about?
Oh, you know, your usual damsel in distress kind of thing. Oh, boy, it's getting kind of late. I gotta go.
We can't go yet, darling. Cassie and Andrew are still here.
Yeah, well, listen, you can stay. It's something I gotta take care of alone.
Oh, alone?
Yeah, it's just, you know, a little personal thing I have to attend to. And don't you trust me?
Luna, where's Max off to in such a hurry?
Hey, now we've got to hurry, all right? If we don't hurry, we're going to be honeymooning off the end of Pier 12.
But I've got to throw the bouquet.
Bouquet, right. Everyone, we are throwing the bouquet. Anyone who's interested,
okay,
please.
Come on.
Okay, come on. We are ready, Kathy. We're ready.
No,
ready.
I wouldn't catch that thing if my life depended on it.
I'm ready.
All right, ready? Okay, here it goes.
I'm ready.
No. Darling, one last kiss. Oh. I had a wonderful wedding, Mother. Thank you.
I'm so glad. Now, you go and have a wonderful honeymoon. And a wonderful life.
We really do have to hurry, sweetie.
Okay. Hey, Sandra, I'm ready.
Bye.
Oh, we
thank you, everybody.
And just about as smart.
No, Blair. You are really sick. You know that? I mean, we could have asphyxiated.
With all the hot air that's inside of you, Kane? No. Anyway, you're free to go. Oh, and regards from all. It was a beautiful wedding.
Don't rub it in, all right?
Of course, Cassie was a little upset that you weren't there, Tina, but not to worry. I told her you were otherwise engaged. You witch. Tina, I am surprised at you, and after I was thoughtful enough to bring you some wedding cake. Huh. Good thing I'm not one to keep grudges, huh? Bye. Oh. Nighty-night.
I'm in the solarium.
There you are.
Well, you found me. Been looking hard?
What's the matter?
Well, you tell me. You're the one who's been missing.
Missing? Mm-hmm. Wasn't missing. Marty Saybrook became ill, and I helped her.
Oh, well, that's you, all right. The great helper.
She was about to ruin Andrew and Cassie's wedding, and I did what I could to prevent it, that's all.
I see. Been there with her all this time?
Well, not exactly, no.
Well, then, what exactly?
I took her home. And I stayed with her a little bit, and, I went for a drive. I just needed to think.
Well, I reckon you've had a lot on your mind.
I have to go and pack. I have the conference tomorrow, and I have to be at the airport in an hour and a half.
Vicky. Do you really have to go to Boston? I was hoping we could talk.
I have to go to the conference, Clint.
Vicky. I'm losing you, aren't I? Just tell me, honey. Yes or no?
Missed the end of your son's wedding reception. Some emergency?
Well, frankly, it's none of your business where I go, but I don't want to fight with you. Not tonight. I don't want to fight with anyone tonight.
You know what? Neither do I.
Good. How about a toast?
With flat champagne?
Oh, it's what they call making the best of things, Dorian. To our children, may they avoid the mistakes we've made, and may they be spared the pain we've endured.
And find happiness now and